سلم يسلم على رسوله الكريم ما بعد. إن شاء الله today we read from شمائل الترمذي. In the part of the meaning of the part of Shema'i, we are learning about the hulya, about the appearance of an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We discussed how an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked in his physical appearance. because remember, learning about the seerah is one whole different chapter. And learning about the physical appearance of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a different chapter. There's two parts here. There is the historic part and one that has to do with the physical structure of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And to learn that, it is also a great part of Iman. And as Allama Iqbal rahimahullah says, that learning about the physical appearance of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will eventually increase the love of him subhanahu wa ta'ala, the level of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam into our heart. And in that, inshallah, we learn about the seal of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the seal of the prophethood that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was blessed with, which is muhr, the seal. And At-Tirmidhi rahimahullah brings 8 ahadith in this chapter from various of the Sahaba, in which he is describing the seal of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and in which he is giving the confirmation of the seal of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that was witnessed by the Sahaba, so the seal of Nabuwa, the seal of the Prophethood, was not something that was invisible. It was very clear, visible to the people. And the ulama have also said that it was the mu'jiza of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because there's also a difference of the opinion. Some ulama says that all the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were blessed with the seal, with the muhr of Nabuwa. Some says no, it was only the khususa, or it was only associated with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he was the last prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with the seal. And also, we need to understand that when the seal was visible on the body of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so the jumhur ulama, majority of the ulama says that it was on the back of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, between the two shoulders, from the birth of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had the seal of Nabuwa between his shoulders from the day his mother gave birth to Nabi. It was not something that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was blessed after he received the prophethood by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because remember, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not set as a prophet until he reached the age of 40. And we learned that in the beginning. But however, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had the best character. He was the most truthful one. The people gave testimony about his sadaqah, and about his being truthful, and about his honesty, and about his respect, even before he was sent as a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But in learning the seerah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in learning this, we can, there are so many hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but I will discuss inshallah one hadith of Salman al-Farsi radiallahu anhu. Because as At-Tirmidhi rahimahullah said, the hadith of the Sahabi, or the one of the Sahabi who went to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that his mother took him to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because he was sick, and the Messenger of gave him some water and after performing wuzu, and while and the Messenger of Allah was performing wuzu, he saw the seed of the Nabuwwah. And there are many other hadiths. But inshallah, I will stick with one of the hadiths of Salman bin Farsi. Inshallah, we will learn in detail about the character of Salman bin Farsi radiallahu anhu later. But Salman bin Farsi radiallahu anhu was very close companion to the Messenger of Allah alayhi wa sallam. He has sacrificed a lot to learn the deen of Islam or to find the truth of Islam. And he also mentioned in his statement that it was mentioned in the other book, in the Torah, in the Injil, or in the Zabur, that a prophet will come who will have the seal on his back, the seal of the Nabuwwah, and that will be the seal of the Nabuwwah. So the seal of the Nabuwwah was not only mentioned in the Ahadith, but also mentioned in the books of other religion, in the book, in the Abrahamic religion, in Torah, in Zabur, in Injil. It is also mentioned in that. Salman al-Farsi radiallahu anhu was one of the great Sahabi. When he migrated to Medina, he ended up being a slave. He was a free man, but he was forced to slavery, and he became the slave of one of the Yahud, one of the Jews of Bani Qurayza. But he was keep on looking for the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he heard from the last priest or the last person under whom he was learning his religion. When he was passing over, he said that you go to Taif, you will go to Hijaz, you will go to Mecca, you will find this person who will not accept the sadaqah, but he will accept the hadith. And he will have the seal, which will be, he described that it will be the size of the egg of a pigeon. And it will have here, in its surroundings. It will be covered with the hair. And this is one of the signs of the Nabuwwah of Prophet Muhammad. So Salman al-Farsi were discussing about him, and the Messenger also respected him so much. And the Messenger used to respect Salman al-Farsi so much due to the fact that when he migrated to Medina, the people of Medina had their relatives. But Salman al-Farsi radiallahu anhu did not have any relatives because he was living from families, from Persia. So he was, he felt lonely. One day the Messenger of Allah alayhi wa sallam, when he saw him sitting upset, he went to the member and he told the Sahaba radiallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Salman minna Ahlul Bayt. Salman minna Ahlul Bayt. The Salman al-Farsi, even though he is not from my family lineage or not from my house, but he is from Ahlul Bayt. He is from my house. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to love him so much. And Salman al-Farsi radiallahu anhu said, when he heard this statement of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it makes him really happy to become the family of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to become amongst the family of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He had a very long life. The ulama have mentioned from 250 years to 350 years that he lived for. And when he was coming to Medina or Mecca, he was forced into slavery. The Yahud asked him to, if you want to become a slave, you have to plant 300 trees, his master, and you will not be free until the fruit of these trees will come. So Nabi sallallahu he went to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He mentioned the whole story, that I want to spend more time with you in your khidmat, but I have to spend a lot of time with my master, fulfilling different tasks. Then he says that my master gave me one condition, that he will free me if I plant 300 trees of dates. And until the time of the fruits or the harvest, I have to stick with him and I have to look after this place. And the Prophet said, it's a very easy task. Take me to the garden, I will help you plant. Salman al-Farsi radiallahu anhu, he took the Prophet with him, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam planted 300 trees with his own hands to help free Salman al-Farsi radiallahu anhu. And the ulama, the mu'arikhin, have clearly stated that a tree of dates takes very long time to give fruits, you know. But and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he planted his trees, he did not plant them in the season, rather he planted them in a different season. And all the trees gave fruits in the same year. The trees gave fruits in the same year, except one tree. So when the Sahaba and the Muslims investigated that, how come when they went to the master of Salman al-Farsi, he says, yes, all the trees are giving the fruits except one. And we made the condition that I will free you only when you have 300 trees giving the fruits. So we have only one, we have 299 or 299 trees giving the fruits. One of them is not giving the fruits, so you have to be under my, you have to become my slave until then. So when they find out, they say that 299 trees was fully planted with the blessed hand of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but that specific one tree that did not give fruits was planted by the hands of Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had to take out that tree and then replant it again, and it gives the fruit the next year. And he was free by his mother, Salman al-Farsi radiallahu anhu. So he gave a step when he says that I came to Medina, or I came to Makkah, this difference of opinion of the ulama. And then when I saw Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I went to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the first day, as I read in the other books, that if you take him to sadaqah, if you take him anything from sadaqah, he will not accept it. So he said, I went the first day to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with a pen filled with the dates, and I said that, oh Muhammad, or all this person, these are a gift, days of sadaqah is for you. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take it away, because we do not accept sadaqah. Meaning we Anbiya alayhi wa sallam do not accept the sadaqah, rather we can accept all the gifts. So Salman al-Farsi took those pack of dates, he came the next day, and he says to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, the only Nabi of Allah, Oh Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not accept Islam yet. He said, oh Muhammad, I have brought a pen of dates which is gift for you. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called the Sahaba, and he went to the pen of dates, he ate from it, and he allowed the Sahaba to eat from it. So Salman al-Farsi radiallahu anhu was looking to find the seed, the last sign that he was looking for to accept Islam. So Nabi, he was wandering around the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rahimahullah have said that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, oh Salman, are you looking to see the seal on my back? So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam removed the upper part of his of the body, of the clothing, and he showed him the seal. And Salman al-Farsi radiallahu anhu accepted Islam right away. This is one hadith who gave testimony that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had the seed. And there is also the statement of the Sahaba that what was written in the specific area of the seed of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the ulama have given a difference of opinion that some ulama says that it was written Muhammadur Rasulullah, that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some ulama says it was written on his, under the seal, the seal fa'anta mansur, oh Muhammad, wherever you go, oh Muhammad, wherever you go, you will be blessed with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So At-Tirmidhi rahimahullah brings this hadith or this chapter right after he is mentioning the describing the description of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam physical appearance. He made a special chapter because learning about the seal of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is also a great information and it's a great mu'ajiza of the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And we need to learn this to see that the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was a true prophet of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. And ulama have given, some ulama says, as Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala also said in the Quran, that, that you are the last Nabi. That is why Allah Subhanahu, you know, you are the last Nabi of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So ulama said, because the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was the last prophet, there was no more prophet coming after him. And remember, whoever is claiming or will claim until the day of Qiyamah are Fasiq, Fajr and Dajjal and are the biggest liar. Because there's no more Nabi coming after, and the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he clearly said in many of the hadith saying, and the khatam al-nabiyyin la nabiyya ba'di wa antum khatam al-umam la ummata ba'di. He clearly stated that I am the last Nabi, there's no more Nabi coming after me. And you are the last Ummah, there's no more Ummah coming after you. So, the seal of the Prophet was also on the body of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam physically, and also on the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the meaning of seal. He, you know, in his coming, he was also the last one. Because when you put the seal on something, this is fine, you know, when a person is writing a letter, you spend time, you know, making paragraphs after paragraphs, and then after you're done writing the paragraphs and the essay and everything, you put in the fold, in the envelope, and then after you close the envelope, then you put the seal on it to confirm that everything is done now. So, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends the chain of the prophets, one after the other, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the seal on the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to show that the Anbiya, the chapter of Anbiya are closed now. The chapter of Rasuls are also closed now. There's no more Anbiya or Rasul coming. You are the last one, and that is why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had the seal, but as we discussed before. So ulama says, all the Anbiya used to have the seal. Some says not all the Anbiya, but all the Rasul who have the book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to have the seal from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the most authentic opinion, it is that the Prophet Allah alayhi wa sallam had it, and he had it because he was the last prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is also one of the mu'jiza of the Prophet alayhi wa sallam, and it is also one of the character of the Prophet Allah alayhi wa sallam. The Sahaba saw it, it was physically on the body, on the, between the two shoulders of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But however, be very careful. Nowadays, unfortunately, we see some pictures of it also. Some people making the pictures of the seal of the Nabuwa of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Remember, it is completely false. No one had the picture of the seal that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had on his shoulder. However, people had the picture of the ring that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to use as a seal also, when he used to write letters to different kings and to different leaders of that time. He would use also his ring as a seal. We have the picture of that, of that. There's a, we can confirm that. But when people send you a picture of the shoulder of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, looks like an Arabian has written things in it, don't believe in it, you don't have any iman in it, because no one, all the ulama have unanimously agreed to that there's no picture of that. And we know some description of it, that how it looked like, the Sahaba have given some description of it, but there's no picture of it. The picture of the seal, of the ring of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is visible, or it is available, one can see. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq at the end to bring about iman in all the mu'jizat of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also we beg God Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with the great sight of the seal of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of Qiyamah. Amin. Wa barakatuhu wa barakatuhu wa sallam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. اللهم نسألك الهدى والتوفيق والعافية لنا، اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا وقلبا خاشعا ولسانا ذاكرا ورزقا حلالا طيبا واسعا. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاك الله خيرا.